All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Man, trying to break things down over here on the West Coast. This is a very special video. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. You and your families. Hope everybody's getting together and spending some time together. If you can't because of COVID, or if you're watching through the windows, hoping the cops don't bust you or something. Oh, my gosh. What a weird year, man. But, hey. Much respect to everybody out there. Much love. Spread love. Give thanks. All those kind of things. This is a good time. And if you have to, do it over Zoom. Check in on the fam. Okay, let's do this thing. This is the top 10. We are no longer calling it Civil War. I don't know what calling it. Platypus Cup? Platypus Bowl? I don't know. I called the Beef Game. Because from our perspective, we're playing them. You know, they might call it the Duck Game. They might call it the Oregon Game. We might call it the Oregon State Game. Whatever the case may be. But I've seen a lot of these. This is the first year I'm not going to be able to go, as all of us can't go. But in my lifetime, I've seen a lot of these. And these are the games that I've seen that I've been able to go to. And these are just amazing games, whether at the Corvallis or at Oregon. I come from a family season ticket holders. My aunt, rest in peace, would not go to the Oregon State game, no matter where it was. So I got her ticket every year at Autzen, and then the other times at Oregon State, I would always ask her to get me one of those tickets through the Oregon Duck package. And so we'd always sit with the Duck section. I would hate to sit everywhere else and just be out in the crowd. It's crazy over there. So you get to sit with the Duck section. It's always fun to represent with the Ducks. So a lot of these games I've been to, I would say all these games I've been to, and these are some of the greatest times. The time in that stadium when that thing's just about to kick off and you're in the state of Oregon and you get to be at that Duck game and that Beef game, the old Civil War we used to call it, it to me is one of the best moments of the year. You know, there was a lot of years when we were growing up that the Ducks and Beeves were not good. They were not going to bowls when I was a kid. This was the end of the year. You had to win this game, have bragging rights on the stadium or on the state for the rest of the year. This was a huge deal. You know, no matter what stadium you were in, there was a time period when I was just coming out of college and then in my early 20s and stuff where the home team won the whole time. So pretty wild times. So let's go ahead and do this. I got honorable mention, the Toilet Bowl. This one you can't put in the top 10, man. It's 0-0 tie. Fumbles, missed field goals, rain, terrible conditions. You know, there was many, many, many of these type of games. This is the only one that just nobody was able to score in. I mean, this is the last, I think, recorded tie in college football, and it's 0-0. You can't get any worse than this. Interceptions, fumbles. I mean, you couldn't go anywhere. Pretty much played between the 30s. Didn't even really break into the red zone. Terrible, terrible situation. But that one is horrible, and that's in Eugene. Okay, let's go number 10. Number 10 is 1990, 6-3 in Corvallis. Okay, this was a huge, huge game. This was the year the Ducks are going to go to the Freedom Bowl. They had just gone to the Independence Bowl the year before. Super hyped, 1989. Unbelievable hype for the Duck fans. The first bowl game in years and years and years. And here we are in a chance to go to two bowls back-to-back. Got to win this game up at Corvallis. It's terrible conditions. We sat, I remember, in the end zone in the wooden bench or in the wooden bleachers up in the end zone. And it got soaked all the way through the game. It was even more wet at the end of the game. They're like a sponge. Nobody sat down. It was raining the entire time. Everybody's wearing ponchos. I mean, you know how these conditions are if you go to these games and if you're from the state of Oregon. Just an unreal game. 6-3. Three field goals. I mean, crazy, crazy time. And then missed field goals late for the Bevos. 1992, 7-0. Very similar. Rain, fumbles, everything else. It's that Willie Tate touchdown. Oh, I love that. The tight end, man. Stud. And that, again, huge. Had to have it. 7-0. So my number 9 is 1992. These are kind of some old ones. 83, 1990, 1992. Okay, 1995 is the year after the Ducks go to the Rose Bowl, the year that they have Mike Bellotti as the head coach for the first time, and they go to the Cotton Bowl. This was a huge game. Ducks had to have this game, and Beavs showed up. This game was so tough, 12-10. This game was insane. I remember it so well in Eugene, you had to have this one. This is the year after the one up in Corvallis that was huge, going to Pasadena. This one felt even crazier because it was at home, more pressure. The Beavs always show up in those moments too, man. They always show up. Number seven, I got the 1989. This is going to the Independence Bowl. This game is huge. Just thinking about this game fires me up because they fumbled the kickoff. If you guys remember these times, this is awesome. If you don't, welcome to memory lane. Go on YouTube. Go check some of these things out. Old Kurt's got tons of these things. Other people have got to have some of these things. I haven't checked to see if all these are on there, but you got to have some of these on there. At least highlights. 89 was huge. That was a big game. It was in Eugene, and they beat them pretty well, 30-21. Number six is the 2001 game. Oh my God, this one could be in top like three for people. This could be the number one game for people. This is a humongous game. This is Joey Harrington's senior year. This is his final game in Eugene. Keenan Howry with the fucking with the return. Unbelievable. This is unbelievable game. I mean, just getting me so fired up even thinking about it. This was at a crucial time. They had just rebranded, just come out with the O. This is the year. This is the Fiesta Bowl year. This is the best year that they had. Had a shot at the national championship, maybe very late, kind of a late look at it. have a Heisman opportunity with Joey. I mean, a lot of stuff on the line. And this game was 17-14. Super, super, super crazy game. The Keenan Howry punt return. I mean, that's just you can't beat that one. Number five, though. Okay, number five I absolutely love. Number five is the 2008. This is the blowout up in Corvallis. This is the one that was crazy. This is the one where there were all sorts of wild plays. Huge long touchdowns. Huge, I mean, just crazy plays. Defensive touchdowns. All sorts of plays. This is the year the Bees could have gone to the Rose Bowl 2 years in a row. This is the first year the Ducks spoiled it for the Beavs. This was a humongous, humongous game. This was the year that they went to the Holiday Bowl. This is Jeremiah Masoli and that whole crew. This was an amazing defense. This is where all these guys, man, all went to the NFL, played great defense. This is LeGarrette Blount era, and this is awesome times. So I really loved that 2008 team. Okay. Number four is the 2010. You gotta love this one because this is the one where the Ducks go to the national championship. This is the one that's the undefeated season. This is the one where Jerry Allen's crying in the press box. This is 37-20. This is the classic moment. Burnt the field and all this sort of stuff. I mean, just crazy stuff, right? This is wild times. And you gotta love that moment. You gotta love that as a Duck fan. Not necessarily burning the field, but the excitement of winning that game and going to that national championship. Okay, top three. For me, because it's my era and what I grew up with, it's the 94 team. Up at Corvallis, unreal. You had to have it. Dino Filios, screen pass late. Dino was so good, so good, so good that year. Ricky Whittle, that team was like easily, that team, you know, the Danny O'Neill squad of that team, and then the Bill Musgrave squad of 89. Absolute my favorite teams, you know. I just absolutely love those guys. Derek Lavelle, Latin Berry. Just amazing, amazing, amazing players. And so again, that 94 team was wild. That game was late. The Beavs were winning that game. They were fired up. They weren't rocking the chainsaw then, but they were fired up and up there to walk out of there. And they were handing out roses. To get roses on the way out of that stadium was just mind-blowing. At that point, I didn't think we were going to go back. I thought that could have been the only time I was going to Pasadena in my life for a Duck game. Okay. The second one, number two, has to be the one-point game, Mariota to Huff at the end. This one is legendary. Went right down to the wire. It's a one-point game. I mean, that says it all. This game was back and forth. This was the game they had to win to go to the Alamo Bowl 2013. This is a crazy game, 36-35. This is a crazy game. This is a game that was just an absolute party atmosphere. One of the largest stadium capacities ever, because that was the year that they had built the new kind of seating up at the top and everything. And the energy in that game was awesome. That year was a year that was kind of a should have been year. You know, obviously a lot of those Chip Kelly years was just one win away from being in the driver's seat. And that was one of those. So it's kind of disappointing, but to win that game, if we would have lost that game, I mean, that would have been all she wrote. To catch it right at the end, though, it was unbelievable play. The number one to me is got to be 2009. Both teams are going for the roses. This is unbelievable. The fact that you would have the Ducks and the Beavs both be able to play for the roses. Come on. That's unreal. That's unreal. As a kid growing up, that was never even a dream. It was just, and now it can never happen again with the Pac-12 championship. It was a one-time deal. You were either there or you weren't. I was up there. I was with my mom and dad. I was with a couple friends sitting in different seats because we couldn't get our other seats and everything. I mean, blah, 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 blah. I mean, it was just crazy, crazy times. And that was, again, an amazing game. 37-33. Jeremiah Masoli had that big first down run. Had to get it, hitting Keaton Kristic on the sideline. That was a huge play. Multiple plays in that game that were to be made, but that was just an amazing Beav team, an amazing Duck team, and to meet each other to be able to go to the Rose Bowl was something tremendous. So that's my little trip down memory lane. Hopefully everybody enjoy themselves. If you guys have thoughts on any of these, great. I wish we could be there, man. This is a real bummer, man, because this is the time that, you know, it's fun to see everybody. It's kind of almost holiday tradition to kind of have the turkey and then go, you know, see the Beavs, you know, and go go play these games. So much love to everybody. Much respect to everybody out there. Happy Thanksgiving and go Ducks. All right. See you guys. Adios.